Yeah, doing an eye opener, evaluating by John.
Fellow Toastmasters and honored guests, the title of my speech is An Eye Opener. As several of you know, I graduated recently from a graduate school program, and it's in transformational leadership. And one of the areas that we studied, we had six core disciplines, and one of the disciplines was neuroscience. One of the concepts in neuroscience that we learned that I thought was so interesting was how the brain adapts. If you have an injury somewhere, say you break your leg, and you have to have a cast on it. Your body's going to adjust for the fact that this side is injured. So this leg may become stronger. So I'm going to give you an example that recently happened to me that kind of hit me in the face with this concept. For 2 years and two quarters, I studied very hard in my master's program. People know how school is, right? You're always studying, you're always reading, you're writing, you're staying up late at night, you're getting up early in the morning, and you're very, very focused on what you're doing, and you don't have a whole lot of time. So, in my case, I wasn't able to do a lot of other things besides school. I had some work projects. I tend to co-author books with people. That's what I do. And so I use my eyes a lot for that too. So after the program was over, this just happened recently, I just graduated and had my commencement ceremony recently. I thought, you know, I don't think I'm seeing that clearly. I think it's time to go have my eyes checked. So I went and had my eyes checked, and they did that, you know, eye chart thing where they put the eye chart up and they're like, cover this eye and cover that eye, and you're supposed to go down and read, you know, each letter. And so I'm in this guy's office, and I saw him 2 years ago, and he remembered me, and I remembered him. Tall, Thai guy, thin, nice man, very interested in what he was doing. So he shows me the first eye chart, and I'm like golden, right? I have my glasses, after all, and he has me read, you know, with my glasses, so I'm fine. So then he goes to the other eye, which is my left eye, and he asks me to read the chart with my glasses, and I literally cannot read any of what's on the chart. And I'm pretty stunned by this. And so she says, this is the technician, she says to me, she's doing the work before the physician, so what can you tell me about this eye chart? And I said, I can't read anything on it, it's a blur, it's like there's just light there. And so she kind of looked down, and then she went and got the doctor, and he said, you know, I think I need to refer you to a specialist. So a couple days go by, I get in too quickly to this specialist, and I'm like, uh-oh, because, you know, when they refer you to a specialist and you get in fast, you know there's a problem. So I get in with this new specialist. She's a short, blonde woman in her late 30s, very pregnant, and she does the exact same things that this other person did, and then she goes, you have a cataract on your left eye that is making you legally blind in your eye. And I'm like, legally blind? And then I'm thinking, cataracts? That's for old people. And I'm thinking, the only people I know that have had cataracts removed is my dad, and he was in his late 80s, and I know a couple other people in their 80s who had cataracts removed. So I say to the doctor, I thought that was for old people. And she says, just calm down. The youngest person that I've treated was 22, and the oldest person was 150. four. So, this whole experience has been an eye-opener for me. And essentially, I have to have cataract surgery, which is evidently not that big a deal these days. A cataract is a cloudy original lens in your eye, and they actually pull the cataract out in pieces and put a new lens in the eye. So they have to cut your eye and then insert this new lens. So I'm actually going to end up seeing better than I have in a long time. But what startled me about this was, wouldn't you think you'd know if you weren't seeing anything out of one of your eyes? So, hey, brain adaptation. My right eye, which is controlled by my left brain, just took over. And aside from a few minor things, I really didn't have any idea that this had happened to me. So, of course, I have to say, I hadn't gone to the eye doctor in 2 years. Now I'll be going to the eye doctor once a year, and I would recommend that you all do too. After a certain age,
thank you very much, Pat.